JBTV is brought to you in part by Pop Chips. Hey JBTV viewers, I'm Jerry Bryant. This is another brand new edition of JBTV from the epicenter of great rock and roll, Chicago, Illinois. Lisa Loeb is in the studio performing live. Ryan Mano has an awesome interview. Hey, it's a flash mob and it's happening at Threadless. Koo Koo Kanga Roo and JBTV invade the warehouse, the t-shirt factory. The employees were taken off guard. In the studio, I have Trenchtown. Plus, on this edition of JBTV, Toby is on location at the Johala Project's Alkaline Trio 15-year retrospective with Heather Gabel. Plus, in the studio, I have the Cowboy Junkies performing live. It's a classic segment. This is JBTV, nonstop style, all this hour, next.
Hey, it's JBTV. I'm Ryan Mano. She is Lisa Loeb. She's our guest this week, performing live and an exclusive interview. Don't go anywhere. Lisa Loeb on JBTV.
Do you eat, sleep? Do you breathe me anymore? Do you sleep? Do you count sheep anymore? Do you sleep anymore? Do you take blight on my tongue like lead? Do you fall gracefully into bed anymore? Saw you as you walked across my room. You looked out the window, you looked at the moon, and you sat on the corner of my bed, and you smoked with a ghost in the back of my head. Now I don't know, and I don't care if I ever will see you again. No, I don't know, and I don't care if I ever will be there. Oh. Do you eat, sleep? Do you breathe me anymore? Do you sleep? Do you keep me anymore? Cause you kick my foot under the table, I kick you back. Can't say I'm able to stand for you or fall for you ever again. I wish for a perfect setting, wishing that I'm letting you take me where you want me all over again. Well, you can't give yourself, no, absolutely, to someone else. Now I don't know, if I ever will see you again. No, I don't know, and I don't care if I ever will be there. Cause I saw you as you walked across my room. You looked out the window, you looked at the moon, and you sat on the corner of my bed, and you smoked the ghost in the back of my head. Do you eat, sleep? Do you breathe me anymore? Do you sleep? Do you count sheep anymore? Do you sleep anymore? Well, I don't know, and I don't care if I ever will be there. We'll be
Lisa, thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me here.
You look great.
Thank you.
You look like, honestly, you look like you did when I had your poster.
Oh.
I didn't really have your poster, but I had the Stay single. I was a fan. I still am a fan.
That's nice. Well, I have some singles at my house if you'd like any.
But really, though, you look like you haven't aged a day. I don't know if you sleep in like a cryogenic chamber or something, but...
I don't. I sleep in a bed. All right. No, but I do. Health is important to me.
Yeah?
It's sort of not a hobby, but, you know, it's kind of like a hobby. I'm really into drinking water, sleeping enough, eating well, eating what I like, too.
What is your preferred, hours of sleep in a night? What do you need?
Right now, I need 8.
Really?
For a while, I only needed like between 6 and 7, but I need 8 now. And sometimes I need to go to sleep like to try to get 9, which I never do, so that I can get 8 because I wake up all night.
Don't you end up though? Maybe this is just me. I end up feeling if I get 8, I feel more tired. Like too much sleep makes you more tired.
Right. You don't need 8 then.
No.
How many do you need? Do you need 7?
Guess how many I got last night. Guess.
Well, now I'm gonna say like 5.5.
2.
Oh.
I was working on something up against a deadline and I got 2 hours of sleep.
But I feel good.
Yeah, it's Friday and you're here.
I don't know, that 2 hours of sleep reminds me of when you go get donuts and you get that really stale coffee and you just feel horrible but kind of awake for a few hours, but then you totally crash and you get a really good nap.
My crash today is going to be epic. It might happen during this interview. Pick
up
your foot and stop
it, stop it. Pick up your foot. Up next on JBTV, Koo Koo Kanga Roo invades Threadless. It's music, mayhem, dancing, and a lot more. Then we go behind the scenes with Lisa Loeb. It's all here next on JBTV.
Hi, I'm Nikki.
I'm Brian from Silverson Pickups, and you're watching JBTV. JBTV!
Hey guys, what's going on? I'm Jenna Martinelli. You're watching JBTV. Today we are on the scene at Threadless Chicago. We're about to go inside with Koo Koo Kanga Roo and do a secret flash mob. Let's go!
Threadless University likes dinosaurs. Do you like dinosaurs?
It's time to dance like dinosaurs. Okay.
You guys are Koo Koo Kanga Roo.
Correct.
Tell me about yourselves. I mean, you're wild, obviously. We just had a dance party.
Koo Koo Kanga Roo is an interactive dance party that, you know, we just put on shows all over the place and, you know, have crazy dance parties. And we make songs about unicorns and rainbows and t-shirts at Threadless. Open the jaws.
Where does your motivation and ideas come from?
Koo Koo Kanga Roo came from lack of any motivation for anything, and we didn't want to get real jobs, so we made up this.
This is Brian. I am a Stegosaurus. Call me a Brontosaurus. I'll get you with my Taurus. Hey, 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 lights! Wait down Jurassic Park, and I'm hanging out after dark. I'm scary like a shark. Hey, 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 hey! I dance with Littlefoot. He gives me great input. We eat at Pizza Hut. Hey, 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 hey! I am a dinosaur. Most of us like to roar. Roll jungles and explore. Hey, 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 hey!
I mean, a lot of bands are doing it right now. Like, they go and do their thing. But you actually do the live show?
Yeah, we're going to be doing the Yo Gabba Gabba live show on the East Coast for about a week and a half. So we're really excited to do that coming up here in a couple weeks.
We like being kids band and fake kids band. Dancing. We're having a good time.
Where can I hear your music? Where could everyone hear your music
if I want to? You can go to KooKooKangaroo.com and you can download it all for pay whatever you want. And you can have all of our songs there and jam to them in your bedroom. And awesome. And then you get ready for the show. So you know all the words, know all the dance moves. So everything's online, KooKooKangaroo.com.
Tyrannosaurus Rex, smashing all your objects. I'll put you in.
Let's hear it.
Hey, 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 hey. I'm in the jungle roaring. But when it gets real boring, I go a carnivore. Hey, 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 hey. Velociraptor name. Eating meat is my game.
Dance, you guys.
Extinction IBK. Hey, hey, hey.
No.
Hey, swoop. There goes a pterodactyl.
Swoop.
Nothing rhymes pterodactyl.
Swoop.
I just love pterodactyls. Hey.
That's the other thing. We just sweat all the time. Like a Koo Koo Kanga Roo show is a super sweaty affair. You gotta be ready to be dripping sweat at the end. So.
You maintain a really nice physique that way.
That's right. Well, you're trying. We gotta stay in shape.
No one's ever said that to me.
I'm sorry.
No one's ever said that to me. I got the love handles.
Stop it! Stop it! Pick up your foot! Stop it! Stop it! Pick up your foot! And come on!
And then we tell a friend, open up.
Open up your jaws and chop it, chop it.
Open up your jaws
and chop it, chop it.
Open up your jaws
and chop it, chop it.
And then we do it again. Come on, come on, come on.
Open up your jaws and chop it, chop it.
Open up your jaws
and chop it, chop it.
Open up your jaws
and chop it, chop it.
Straight to the end. Enjoy the rest of your day, you guys. We're Koo Koo Kanga Roo. Thanks.
So what else? What are you guys into other than this crazy music, fun dancing,
Brian, what are you
cool
into?
T-shirts?
What are you into?
Well, we only wear one T-shirt. We just wear this.
It's a cool T-shirt.
Thanks.
Oh, thanks.
Can't wait till Threadless picks it up on their line.
Threadless, come and do a Threadless.
We like gummy bears. But I enjoy finding new Thai food out of the box and new flavors of ice cream.
You think you were gonna grow up and like be a kid again and do a kid show? And
my mom tells me to grow up.
So, what do you want to be when you grow up?
I want to be a firefighter.
We grew up into a kid's band is what happened.
Thanks for hanging out, guys. It was awesome dancing with you. We're out of here. I'm Jenna Martinelli, JBTV on the scene at Threadless.
Up next on JBTV, we're taking you behind the scenes with Lisa Loeb, plus a live performance on our JBTV high-definition soundstage.
Hey, this is Diane Birch, and you are watching JBTV.
So here's our studio. This is where
nice.
All the famous interviews have been done for many years. Have you ever seen our show before?
Yeah, I've seen it online.
Oh, you have?
Yeah.
So you know what we're all about. It's sort of a free form, you know. Just, we're all about the music and great artists like you. So we're so happy to have you here.
Yeah, it reminds me of growing up. I used to be a DJ and I'd interview musicians.
What station?
It was in Dallas. It was my high school station.
Oh, wow.
88.5.
Wow.
And we'd interview a lot of musicians. We would interview them freelance, but we got to play the music that we liked, and we got to, it was really about music.
Back here, we have an archive that goes back 26 years.
Like,
I got all your music videos that we've been playing on the show over all these years.
I love it.
So which was your favorite video you did?
I think my favorite video, Stay was the one that is the most original, probably, and it brought the most success.
Mm-hmm.
But I have to say the one that was based on the firecracker artwork, the one for I Do, the video looked great.
Yeah.
This guy Phil Harder directed it. It's beautiful.
This is the core of the facility here. This is where I have all the concerts, like the late great Jeff Buckley,
oh, yeah.
Radiohead, Sponge. You name it, we probably have them on the wall here.
Oh, look.
Oh, Lisa Loeb. I love it.
So you're right on there.
Oh,
so
cool.
I've actually archived every music video that's come in since day one in sort of chronological order. So this is like a moving, living history of music. All the different bands that have been on JBTV, including your performance today, we're going to have a track sheet.
Ah.
And these are all the different bands that have performed on the stage that you're going to be on.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
You say I only hear what I want to. So all the time, so. And I thought what felt simple, and I thought that I don't belong. And now that I am leaving, now I know that I did something wrong, 'cause I missed you. I don't listen hard, don't pay attention to the distance that you're running to anyone, anywhere. I don't understand if you really care. I'm only hearing naked, no bad. So I turn the radio on, I turn the radio up, and this woman was singing my song. Lover's in love and the others run away. Lover is crying 'cause the other won't stay. Some of us hover and we weep for the other who was dying since the day they were born. Well, this is not that thing that I'm thrown, but I'm thrown. And I thought I'd live forever, Now I'm not so sure you try to tell me that I'm clever, but that won't take me anywhere or anywhere with you. And you said that I was naive, and I thought that I was strong. Oh, I thought, hey, I can leave. Oh, now I know that I was wrong, 'cause I missed you. Me 'cause you want me, and one day I'll let me go. You try to give away a keeper, or keep me 'cause you know you're just so scared to lose. And you say, stay. And you say, I only hear what I want to. Thank you very much.
Still to come on JBTV, we have Trenchtown in the studio, plus a great tour and interview. It's all next on JBTV.
We're Maps and Atlases.
And this is
JBTV.
Not my love, if the shadows in your eye hide the sun. Fear not my love, we were beautiful, a lot more still to come. When the waves crash down and take our ground.
So here we are, another great segment on JBTV. In the studio, I have Trenchtown, an amazing band from Michigan. Am I correct with that?
Originally.
So tell us about the early days of. Now you had another band before this, and then you changed, and you actually went through Chicago on the Warp Tour. Right?
We did, in fact. For 13 years, actually, Mike, Ryan, myself, and Eric, we were Mary's Eyes. So no, we wanted to. We really wanted to kind of like rebirth the band, sort of. We were on the West Coast. We added a member in Greg. We wanted to change the name to kind of make it a little more marketable. You know, spell it how it sounds, one word. You know, reflect the sound sort of that we're playing. So it's been a brand new process. It feels good to kind of have like a fresh slate and move forward. And
when the waves crash down and take our ground, and the floods make truce like gold.
Is there a Trenchtown in the USA?
That's Detroit.
That's Detroit, okay. Yeah. How is it when you go back through Michigan? Do they remember you there?
It's wonderful.
I mean, so you got like
was there last night, yeah.
So is the crowd different?
Yeah, it's
I mean,
it's
like
great,
they treat you
man.
Differently now that you're, you know, moved to LA and everything?
No. It's the same. Just like crap.
Yeah?
No, they're all great. We love going back to Michigan playing shows.
Well, I love your latest video. It's called Waves, right?
Yep.
And you guys ruined all this equipment. So why did you do that? You got microphones, you got drum sets floating in the ocean.
That's the magic of Craigslist right there.
I think that song barely made it on too. Like we were about ready to jump right into the studio and you
Waves?
Know, yeah, Waves. And Ryan basically we were all sitting there and he's like, well, I've got this one song, you know, like check it out. And he played like the first verse and the chorus, and I was like, oh, it's going on. You know, I don't care what we have to do to like make it work.
So it's your fault that it got released.
Yeah,
this is really cool.
No, not so much, but you know, like I just heard it and it was like stuck in my head instantly, and I was like, this has to go on there. Like, you know, we'll make it work.
So tell us about some of your songs, where they all come from, and how do you write them and everything?
Well, Ryan really is like a primary songwriter in the band. Like he'll bring a lot of ideas and melodies and things to the table, and we all kind of, it's like a big meat grinder. We throw all these ideas in there and we grind it up, and what comes out is what's on Against the Sun, the new release, you know?
RB Special.
It is. Yeah.
So when do you do your writing?
Just randomly, you know, like pretty much any time during the day or night. Never really in one sitting. I mean, the song Waves probably came
in the bathroom.
In the bathroom. Isn't that where all songs come from?
I think so, yeah.
There's great acoustics in the bathroom, right?
Have you ever recorded in the bathroom?
I actually have.
Oh, yeah.
GarageBand.
Absolutely.
Yep. Wow.
It's the best acoustics, really. I mean, living room with like a carpet and couches, that doesn't sound
good. It just doesn't cut it.
Well, great. Well, have a great time at Reggie's here in town. And stay tuned. We have a lot more music right here on JBTV. Still to come, this is your nonstop show from downtown Chicago with Trenchtown.
Hey, we're Trenchtown, and this is JBTV.
I want to do a special birthday for Jerry. It's Jerry's birthday today, you guys. Will you sing with me? Woo! Is that too high? Happy birthday. That's pretty high. Happy. That's a lot lower. Oh, you people. Just kidding, wait. A G and an F. Ha, ha, ha. G is like the perfect key, but we don't have, or C. Happy, let me see. One, two, three. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jerry. Happy birthday to you. Yay! I hope you have some delicious cake.
This has been the best birthday ever. Lisa Loeb actually played a song for me on stage. It's amazing. Toby's back in town with the Joe Holla Projects along with Heather Gabel and her Alkaline Trio Retrospective. It's horror punk at its finest, and it's all up next on JBTV.
Hi, we're Cloud Cult, and this is JBTV. JBTV!
Check it out. This is Heather Gabel. She is the belle of the ball, so to speak. Tell us about your show, what it's called. Tell us.
Okay. This show is called Black and White and Red All Over. It's a visual history of all the... It's like a retrospect of everything I've ever done for Alkaline Trio, like over the past 15 years.
I mean, obviously, beyond the shirts and the memories and the shows, people have, like, the tattoos, which is, you know, something that's kind of cool. I mean, and that's sort of your image that you guys, you kind of perfected. And, I mean, how many tattoos are there in the world? Thousands.
I don't know. Yeah, people ask me that one all the time, and they're always like, how does it feel? And it's cool, but I don't feel like that's even... like mine or something that I made. It's
right.
Like a
it belongs to everybody, man. Yeah.
They took that over. And...
I know this is like, you probably get this a lot, but like, there's gotta be a cool story that somebody came up to about how your imagery was so inspiring beyond like, you know, goes beyond like what the band is doing.
When I made a lot of those shirts, I tried to make something that I thought was cool that I would want to wear, like, even if I didn't like the band. Uh-huh. So that was always my motivation.
Yeah.
And like, I guess it worked because people, you know, got like kind of fanatic about like having all the different shirts and I think it kind of, but people get crazy. I mean, people are fanatic about Alkaline Trio though, so I don't know what the difference is. But when they take the leap and like get into like my fine art, like aside from the band and get tattoos of that.
That's also
like that,
really cool, I'm sure.
Yeah, it's really awesome.
Cool.
It's really cool.
Would you be so kind as to like maybe go into the gallery and maybe just show us three pieces that you think are especially noteworthy? I mean, there's so much stuff, but could you show us like three pieces? Shall we?
Do you want to pick? You pick, and then I'll tell you about them.
That sounds excellent. Also, we've got people come down here. We're getting evicted from our stairwell. We got to go back into the throngs. Right, here we go. It's hot in here, or is it just us? Here's one I got for you, Heather. When I've known you guys for about 10 years now. And
I remember the first time I saw you.
Oh God! You want to talk about it?
Yeah, it was in Vegas for the bowling tournament.
That's right.
And, like, we found out we were gonna play you the next day.
Oh, that's right.
And I was going up the escalator.
Yeah.
And you were going down the escalator.
Yeah.
And we were giving each other like simultaneous dirty looks. Like,
that's true.
Come on, tomorrow.
We did actually bowl against each other, and that was right about the time that Alkaline Trio's popularity was exponentially blown up. And it had a lot to do with the fact that you guys lost to our bowling team. But we're still cool now, right?
We are.
Okay, so that was the first time. It was like kismet, man. Synergy at that time.
Like, and we had the same dirty look on our faces.
Right, and not long after that, I got an Alkaline Trio shirt. And the first Alkaline Trio shirt was this thing right here.
You got that one?
On a red shirt, yeah. I still have it somewhere.
That's awesome.
So what do we got here? It looks like some hooch.
Yeah, that was like this. It's some hooch. It's this was like an offspring from when I made this flyer.
Oh.
I was like looking for cool old bottles, and I found that one, and I really liked it. And so I made that. And then you can tell it's old because there's stars. Stars are so like late 90s.
I wouldn't be caught dead with a star right now.
I know.
Okay, so that's the first one I picked. How about you go next?
Okay, like off the wall?
Absolutely.
Oh, jeez. Okay, Chicago, eh?
That is Chicago. Turns out that's a modification of the Chicago flag, which has been done a lot of times, and you see that with bands. And that's something about Alkaline Trio, I guess, and a lot of bands that are their contemporaries around here. They all have this like love for Chicago, and you lived here.
I did, yeah.
What do you think? That probably has something to do with the popularity of the band.
Being from Chicago?
Yeah, and the fact that it's a very like super tight music community and the tight punk scene.
I totally agree. Because I think there's always so many shows here and there's so many venues and people really like to have their, it's like the big shoulders thing. I don't know what it is.
Yeah.
Like it's just Midwestern people like, they're like, I'm not doing a good job of describing.
I'm from the West Coast, so I'll just take your word for it. What I've never ever seen before, and that's an orange Alkaline Trio shirt.
Sure, I know. Everyone's like, that one doesn't belong. But when they first started playing shows, we would just go to the thrift store and buy like whatever shirts they had that were cheap and silkscreen on there. So there's like striped ones. There's like little polos. There are all sorts of weird.
And have
shirts
you kept
there.
The sort of? Have you kept most of the art and stuff like that? You've tried to keep it
this
all.
I have almost everything. There's a few shirts that I don't have. Like that one, the girl with the goat, I don't have that.
Yeah.
I don't have, there's a couple that I don't have the art for anymore, but most of them I do because it's all just like, you know, they're all just pieces of paper. It's not hard to hold on to.
It is, yeah. And considering all like the satanic stuff, like there's a real shortage of goats, wouldn't you say?
Oh, totally.
I
know. We need to bring back.
We've only scratched the surface in terms of how many like offensive, anti-mom shirts and imagery we could possibly do. Heather, one last high five before we go. All right, thank you. And any last words?
No, I got nothing, but thank you very much.
A little Hail Satan?
Hail Satan!
That's what I'm saying. All right, thank you, everybody. True to the theme of the evening, we're going to let this one die. I'm Toby from JBTV, and we're signing off from Heather Gabel's Black and White and Red All Over show. Bye, y'all.
Ryan's in the studio with Lisa Loeb, and they're talking about Lisa's new children's book.
And on the record, Steve Martin plays banjo on it.
Get out. Yes. How did that happen?
It's an exclusive interview and performance all on JBTV next.
Wiz, chill!
Okay.
Keeps!
What?
And
that is the creative process in a nutshell. JBTV. JBTV!
So you have been, you know, kind of detouring away from music for a bit, although there is music involved here.
Yeah, it's less of a detour away from music, maybe a detour away from grown-up music.
This is
my third children's project.
Right, and I'm guessing, you know, if you weren't a mom, would this project have happened?
You know, I think it might have.
Really?
I'm sorry. But I think the first two things I did for kids, I did a record called Catch the Moon, again with my friend from college, Elizabeth Mitchell. She's got a great children's music career happening, and she's also in the band Ida.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
The
Tickle, 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 Little Sack of Sugar. Do you know
exactly,
that song?
Exactly, yeah.
Yes.
So anyway, that's
so
Liz, and we made a kids record together called Catch the Moon that she produced. And then a few years later, I made a follow-up record called Camp Lisa, which was my love of summer camp and summer camp songs. And because of that, Sterling Publishing, this book publishing company, asked if I would do a book for them, an illustrated book.
Mm-hmm.
So this is sort of inspired by my summer camp experiences, and it's definitely enhanced by the fact that I have a daughter. We were recording this when I was pregnant with her. And as I move forward doing more kids' projects, I think having a child will definitely influence what I do. But I love kids' music that sounds like grown-up music, that's fun, that has interesting lyrics. I love a nice, funny, illustrated book. This is really cute illustrations by Ryan O'Rourke.
This is called The Disappointing Pancake.
Yeah, this is The Disappointing Pancake.
What's this song about?
This song is about a very disappointing pancake that at breakfast disappoints everybody, but throughout the day, the pancake proves not to be so disappointing after all, mm-hmm. just like you and me.
Right.
And on the record, Steve Martin plays banjo on it.
Get out.
Yeah.
How did that happen?
I called him up and I said, hi, this is Lisa. can you come play banjo on a song of mine called The Disappointing Pancake? And I wrote this song with Michelle Lewis and Dan Petty, who are my collaborators on a lot of the original songs in the book.
Yeah.
But Steve Martin called me back and left me a message that he was interested and he came to the
studio.
So wait,
is that really how it happened? Like, did you call Steve Martin and then
I called Steve Martin and then he called me back and I was driving in my car and, sorry, I'm still trying to get comfortable.
No, you're fine.
I was driving in my car and I saw that I had messages and I listened to the message and he was like, hi, this is Steve Martin. Got your message.
Crazy.
And I was like in my car by myself.
Right.
Just like, oh my God.
And
this is so cool.
And
just call me back.
You know, I've seen him play banjo and he's really talented.
Yeah,
he's
really,
really
is. And he's very serious with the banjo. So he did come to the house.
Yeah.
And he brought his banjo and he was wearing a suit and he played his parts and, you know, we worked with him like we work with other musicians, making some suggestions. Mm-hmm. He came up with some stuff and he played.
That's awesome.
So yes, I did call him.
Is this a song that you do live? Will you play this
one? I'll play Disappointing Pancake.
Excellent. Let's see Disappointing Pancake from Lisa Loeb. It's live on JBTV.
It's always breakfast Thursday nights for dinner time. Orange juice, oatmeal, eggs, and waffles served at 5. But once there was something I didn't recognize. It was harder than the table, so I thought it was my plate. I hit it with a hammer, but it wouldn't even break. It slipped upon some syrup and the butter ricocheted. And it rolled and it rolled and it rolled and it rolled the disappointing pancake. Rolled and it rolled and it rolled and it rolled the disappointing pancake. Rolling towards the baseball field just down the road. The pitcher on the mound was winding up to throw. The crowd yelled, batter, batter, he felt so at home. He rolled right up to the catcher who had somehow lost his mitt. Who put the pancake on his hand and like a glove it fit. And then he caught the final ball he surely would have missed. And they cheered and they cheered and they cheered and they cheered for the disappointing pancake. They cheered and they cheered and they cheered and they cheered for the disappointing pancake. The catcher threw his pancake mitt into the sky. The wind picked up the pancake sword 4 miles high. And when he finally landed, it was just in time for a bike rider who hit a bump, his tire needed air. The pancake rolled right in and made a temporary spare. They pedaled to the bike shop where they'd get a quick repair. And they rode and they rode and they rode and they rode on the disappointing pancake. They rode and they rode and they rode and they rode on the disappointing pancake. It was a manhole cover in Manhattan, a lily pad in Padua, sombrero in some little town in Spain. Satellite and Saddle River, knee patch in Saskatchewan, a coaster on the chilly coast of Maine. The pancake made its way around the world, rolling in and helping where he could. And then I went outside and saw a glow. Maybe it's the moon or just a UFO. The pancake fell down from the heavens to my bed and landed like a pillow underneath my head, where I dreamt sweet pancake dreams as I slept. The pancake disappointed me at breakfast, yes it's true, but there are many other things that this pancake can do. I'd like to think this pancake is a bit like me and you. And we roll and we roll and we roll and we roll like a disappointing pancake. We roll and we roll and we roll and we roll like a disappointing.
roll and we roll and we roll and we roll. Not so disappointing, pancake.
I'm taking it back to the good old days. Margot with the Cowboy Junkies performs live. It's a classic performance and interview, so stay here on JBTV next. So here we are on JBTV with the Cowboy Junkies. Actually, we just have one junkie, if you want to call it that. So it's a great CD, and you have a whole pile of new music coming out, don't you?
Yeah, it's Pale Sun, Crescent Moon, and it's new. Mm-hmm. It's new in the stores now.
And here it is. A copy of it there.
Have you ever felt more fresh or wonderful than on a warm fall night under a mackerel sky, the smell of grapes on the wind?
You got two new videos coming out. The first of the two new videos
is Floorboard Blues, which was done by a NYU student with $500.
Wow.
So it's really quite amazing. I should know his name, but I don't. Isn't that terrible? Well, I think you have to have a good song, and for as far as the director, I think you have to have a lot of good friends, because I think he used every friend he knew, mm-hmm, helped on this, and I think the $500 went towards lunch. Everything else was donated. So.
That was one lunch, yeah.
Have you ever satisfied a gut feeling to follow a rider road that's beckoning you to the heart of a shimmering summer's day?
And you carried a whole thing of your lyrics along, didn't you?
Yeah, you saw my cheat notes.
Yeah. But you typed them all out. You didn't, like, just write them out. You did it the right way.
Yes. Well, that way you can throw them on the floor and see them. I try not to do that, but unfortunately my brain doesn't always work the way I want it to.
So you've been traveling all around. What's the best city you like so far?
Well, I mean, to be honest, I've always liked Chicago, and that's not a lie just because I'm here.
So much more brighter when...
So when you're on stage and you're singing, does something like take over sometimes?
Oh yeah, if things are going really well. I mean, if the boys are, you know, happening and everything's in the right groove, yeah. I sometimes wonder how I get to the end of the song. You know, like you wake up and, there's an audience. I got to say something now. And it's such a really nice feeling when that happens. And usually it happens for a whole show, in that the rhythm just happens. It's just really natural. There's no thought involved. And then the other side of the spectrum is your head's going, what's the next line? Oh my God, what should I say? What's the next song?
There's a cup of coffee in a welding ring. In a welding ring.
Another favorite of ours in my house is a song called Fried Ham. And it's funny, because I had my friends, Alma Dahl and Shannon, who I went to summer camp with in Texas at Camp Champions. I had them try to help me, remind me of all these songs we used to do. And one of them was a song that I'm gonna sing, but it's funny, when it got down to recording it, I realized I didn't know what the melody was. I don't think we actually had a melody. We just would sing it standing on the picnic tables in at camp, you know, in the cafeteria, in our bunk beds, out on the lake in these inner tubes, and it goes like this. It's it always make me hungry. It goes like this. Fried ham, cheese and bologna, and after the macaroni, we'll have onions, pickles and pretzels, and then we'll have some more fried ham, same, next verse, same as the first. Texas accent makes it worse. Fried ham, cheese and bologna, and after the macaroni, we'll have onions, pickles and pretzels, and then we'll have some more fried ham. Third verse, same as the first. Opera accent makes it worse. Fried ham, cheese and bologna, after the macaroni, we'll have onions, pickles and pretzels, and then we'll have some more fried ham. Fourth verse, same as the first. What kind of accent would make it worse? Italian? Oh my gosh. I don't even know how to do Italian or Russian. I shouldn't have asked. I'm not asking you. Do you want to sing it now? Fried ham, fried ham. I don't even know what that is. What is it? Valley Girl? Oh my God, I know that. fried ham, cheese and bologna. We probably did that back in the 80s too. After the macaroni, we'll have onions, pickles, and pretzels. That was actually my real accent, I think, in the 80s. And then we'll have some more fried ham. Thank you very much. And I do.
Still to come on JBTV, Lisa Loeb has a final performance along with a great interview. It's all up next on JBTV. JBTV is brought to you in part by Rock Razor Scissors, Do312.com, and Emperor Cabs.
I want to talk about the reality show a little bit, because that's one thing that you know, a lot of people were mentioning to me this week when I was, again, telling them that you were coming up here. I hate reality TV, and Lisa, I promise you, I was addicted to your show.
Why?
I don't know if it was the production. I don't know if it was... I think it was because, like, you were just so likable as, like, a main character. You know, if you watch TV, it's like, on almost every show, someone's like... trashy or like disgusting, and yours was just such a change of pace. It was a breath of fresh air. It was great.
It was important. It was weird. You know, we were talking about doing a reality show, and I thought that was a really bad idea, because I actually was looking to try to meet a nice person at the time, and I thought about it some more, and I realized that I had a story to tell, to share with other people, that there were a lot of people I thought who might be able to relate to me. And who I represented, people who were in their 30s, who work, who are looking for somebody to meet. And also, again, like you said, not trashy, not over the top. It was a little bit weird because E! Television decided to put the show on the air. Another network wanted me to be more emotional and more crazy, and I was like, I can't do that. I'm just who I am. I'm not like crazy and emotional. I have emotions, but I'm not, you know, you don't have to have
a
crazy
snooky
person. Exactly. Well, you know, she's who she is. So, again, I wanted to make the show really like... My experience was as a person who, I am a musician, but it was more about a working person, a woman who's got a career, friends and family, and how life is. So I'm really glad you related to it. That was the only, you know, that was a good thing that came out of it, was that now I get to talk to a lot of people, especially women, about their relationships. And that's really important to me, to hear people and how their lives are going, and maybe not even just relationships, but just talk about life. That's important to me.
Did it not work out? Did you not find love?
I didn't find love on TV.
Was it because there were cameras in your face the whole time? Did that have anything to do with it? Is it just awkward to try and, you know?
It is. Having a camera in your face. No. Having a camera in your face can... It's definitely extra people around. I think it helped me learn a lot about myself and about... Made me think about what I'm looking for, what I was looking for at the time in relationship. I ended up meeting somebody a couple years after that. And I have a child. So,
congratulations.
Thank you. That's and great. It did bring me to New York City, which I really wanted to spend more time in New York.
The song How?
How, yeah.
It was I know someone requested it today on Twitter.
Yes, it's a song that gets requested a lot. It was a song that I think is on my Firecracker album, but I wrote it for the movie Twister, which is a movie about a tornado.
Right.
And it's been used in that movie and also in a movie called Jack Frost. And, people often request it. I think it's because the lyrics are about people in your life challenging you and asking you for answers to questions that to you are really obvious, and you're just kind of exhausted with the whole idea of having to deal with these questions that are asked of you.
Right.
I don't know if that makes sense.
Yeah, it does. Well, let's see it. How? Lisa Loeb is live on JBTV.
Come this far for you to make this hard for me, and now you want to ask me how. It's like, how does your heart beat and why do you breathe? How does your heart beat and why do you breathe? Why did you come here? Well, you weren't invited. Well, you were on the outside. Well, then stay like, why does your heart beat? And how do you cry? Why does your heart beat? And there are some things that I'd like to figure out. Yeah, there are some things that I can do without. Like you and your letters that go on forever. And you and the people who were never friends. Never friends. Never friends. With all the things that you could be, you never could learn how to be me. Now you want to ask me how. It's like, how does your heart beat? And why do you breathe? How does your heart beat? And why do you breathe? Thank you. Thank you very much.